Everyone in my family, mostly my brother, my two brothers, one in Canada and another one, a businessman in Burundi, were against me marrying my lovely wife here for the only reason that she has a son. And maybe they are afraid that son will need a part of a land from my side. I said you can go to hell. You are not the one marrying her. I'm the one marrying her. If I'm here in Kenya, I haven't been able to buy a land. Mm-hmm. And I rent a house and they live in. She asked me to give her a shoe. Mm-hmm. And then I gave her a shoe. She put water in my shoe. Mm. She gave my wife to drink.
Eh?
Yes.
Why?
And she drank.
Hello, welcome to Tuko Talks. My name is Lynn Ngugi. Now, my guest today knows what it feels to be rejected and shamed by family and friends for marrying what they consider the wrong woman. But if there's one thing he's clear about, is the fact that he does not plan on giving up on his wife and two children anytime soon. So without further ado, please allow me to let him introduce himself. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Please introduce yourself.
Yeah, thank you very much. My name is Gerald Nitunga. Gerard Nitunga.
Gerard.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a French name. I'm from Burundi. And I live in Kenya since 2002 up to now. Mm-hmm. So Kenya has become my home. Yeah. So also, getting married to Kenya made Kenya my home also. Mm-hmm. Again. Mm-hmm. Now, I was born in 1982 and born in a poor family because my dad passed on when I was 7 years old. Now, when in Burundi, back to Burundi,
yeah.
Burundi experienced a lot of war, and at that time there were war. When I was in primary school, mm-hmm. I finished. I joined secondary school. Mm-hmm. After 2 years, when I finished the second year in secondary school, I was ambushed and taken to the bush, and they trained us.
The army ambushed you?
No, the rebels.
The rebels.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I was devoted to studies. Even if they ambushed me, I didn't want to join them. So I decided to escape. But if you try to escape and you're caught, that was a death penalty. So I decided to do it in a wise way. So I accepted to do training. I finished training. And our first mission to go to attack the army, the regular army, mm-hmm. I decided to escape. Mm-hmm. I escaped I slept. I managed to escape. But that day, they sensed that I was gonna escape. Mm-hmm. And then because I looked the way of handing over, mm-hmm. what did not belong to me.
Yeah.
Now you understand what I mean.
Yes.
A gun and other stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and they sensed, and I was beaten almost up to death. And I remember blood was falling down like tears or how do we call it? Okay, like water from the head. Mm-hmm. Finally, the human rights intervened, mm-hmm. and I was released. I was placed under care. And then after that, I came to Kenya as a refugee.
Oh, you came to Kenya as a refugee?
Yes. Okay. Because the rebels and the army, if either of them could see me, I was finished. I could have, it was dead, mm-hmm. death penalty. Mm-hmm. Now, I came to Kenya as a refugee. And I went to register with UNHCR. I lived here. When I arrived, I did my English course mm-hmm. for 6 months. And then I went back to school to finish my secondary studies. Mm-hmm. After I finished, I did also my university studies. Mm-hmm. And then after I finished on my way to clear with the university, mm-hmm. I met my beautiful wife. That's Christine Mutungi, Ndulu Mutungi. Oh my goodness. You know what? It's really amazing how I met her.
How did you meet her?
Yeah. I met her on Facebook. I know many people will not believe this, but it's true. Uh-huh. I met her on Facebook, and and I'm the one who started to write to her. Why did I write to her? I saw the name Mutungi. So the name Mutungi in our language means, how do we call it? Mutungi.
Like jerrycans?
Yes. Like jerrycan.
The ones used to carry water?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So I said, this lady called Mutungi, this is a funny name. Little did I know that I have found my soulmate. My life partner. So I said, as if I was teasing her. Hey, how are you, Mutungi? She said, okay. Yeah, we continued chats, and then all of a sudden she disappeared. She never appeared online. And I continued to write to inbox her. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, how are you doing? How is everything? And when she came back, she told me that she was sick. She had been sick, and then now she was feeling better. Mm-hmm. I said, I'm sorry. And then we planned how we could meet.
Hey.
And then we met. I think the first day we met, I was doing an interview to go to Italy mm-hmm. in a Psychosynthesis International Conference. So we met while I was in a hurry, and she was also a bit nervous meeting me for the first time.
But
and
how was it like when you saw her for the first time?
I saw her for the first time.
Yeah.
Actually, she was fat. She was fat at that time. And I said, oh, this is Mutungi. Okay, now I was nervous, and I was rushing to the Italian embassy, mm-hmm. so we could not talk much. Mm-hmm. And then we did the interview. It did not go through. So with all the stress, I went home, and then I did not come back to her. And she started communicating with me, asking me, "You did not like me because he did not come back to me." But she did not know it was because of the stress of the interview, mm-hmm. which did not go well. And then I said, no, that's not how it is. In fact, I liked you. And what made me love her so much is that she told me the truth. Now, she told me, you didn't like me, maybe it's because I have a son. I said, oh, you have a son? you didn't tell me, but we did not have much time to talk about it. It's okay, children are the blessings of God. I told her that way. Yeah, don't worry about that. It's okay, we shall plan another meeting and then we talk about everything. We met, she told me everything, I told her everything. And then I said, oh, if this lady we met for the first time, and she told me even she has a son, and
she's honest
and she's frank. And now I needed someone to spend the rest of my life with. Now, if she can agree she can reflect what I want in a woman. Mm-hmm. Now, I think she's the best for me. Yeah, uh-huh. She's the best for me.
Uh-huh.
Now I drive. I tried to find out if she could meet what I wanted in a woman.
What were you looking for in a woman?
Okay, what I wanted in a woman, I wanted first someone who loves me for who I am. Yeah, I didn't have anything at that time, and I was looking for a job everywhere, and also I needed someone who can support me, who is supportive, and someone who is ready mm-hmm. to embark on a journey with me.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
If I say that we go to Burundi,
you are going to Burundi.
We are both going to Burundi.
Okay.
If I say we are staying in Kenya,
we stay in Kenya. Oh, okay.
Yes.
Yes.
This is what I wanted. You know, many people, they don't like to change environment.
Mm-hmm.
They say, oh, no, yeah, I don't want to go to Burundi. We live here. So she was all that. She was all that, and she still is that.
Mm-hmm.
And when we met, I was having in mind to go back to Burundi to look for a job, since I had finished my studies.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, now that we love each other and we understand each other, now let's do this. Let's go to Sharia House, to attorney.
Yes.
We sign a contract of marriage.
Mm-hmm.
And then I go to Burundi, since you are still in school, you finalize your studies.
Yeah.
And then you join me there. While I'm preparing something over there, I'm looking for a job and then settling.
Yes.
And then that's what we did.
Mm-hmm.
We went to attorney, but everyone in my family, mostly my brother, my two brothers, one in Canada and another one, a businessman in Burundi, were against me marrying my lovely wife here for the only reason that she has a son. And maybe they are afraid that son will need a part of a land from my side.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Inside, I said you can go to hell. You are not the one marrying her. I'm the one marrying her. If I'm here in Kenya, I haven't been able to buy a land.
Mm-hmm.
And I rent a house and they live in. Yeah. If I will be able to educate my son, now my son, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
And not be able to buy a land so that I can he can inherit it.
Uh-huh.
He will survive the way I do. If he's lucky enough, I be able to buy a land, it will be his when I pass out, when I die. So a child is a blessing. So there is no way you can tell me not to marry a wife who is a son, or who has a son. And more thing, they said that you were a learned person, and she's not a learned person, so you can't get married to her. They said, you can go to hell. Going to school, she can still go to school.
Even after you're married?
Yeah, even after you marry her. And then they said, okay, now you have disobeyed us. Now we will have to punish you. Now they found a wife for me in Burundi.
Hey.
Yes, they planned, they found a wife for me in Burundi. I noticed it and I told them I can't get married to that wife. My wife is Christian.
And she's in Kenya.
And she's the one who will bury me. She's in Kenya, and for your information, we are already legally married. Actually, I did it secretly. No one knew it.
Why?
Because
why?
They were against it.
Uh-huh.
Yes. Uh-huh. Only my mom was not against it.
Yeah, what was mom saying and what was mom telling your brothers when they tell you cannot marry that woman, she's not educated, or what is mom telling you and what is she telling these people?
Yeah, by the way, mom is I think she is a wonderful mom in the world.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because mom, she said, Gerard, you have chosen your wife. You are the one who knows what you like, what you love your wife for.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you have chosen your wife wisely, I give you full support. And for those brothers of yours who are against it, just leave them alone.
Mm-hmm.
Just don't listen to them. Go on with your wife. I bless you. I bless you. May God continue to bless you, and so that you can prosper. They also offered me money so that I can get rid of her, so that I can just abandon her.
Wow.
Yeah, they gave me 5 million Burundian money.
Yeah.
At that time, it was around 300, between 300 and 400 thousand Kenyan money.
Mm-hmm.
So that I don't continue with my wife. I just get married to the
Burundian
one.
Mm.
But I said, you can, I told my brother, yeah, I know you are my elder brother and I respect you so much. How much can someone offer you so that you can abandon your wife? Now you are offering me 5 million to abandon my wife. Now, you being you, how much can someone offer you to abandon your wife with the 3 kids you have? And he looked at me and he was speechless. And then I said, you can go to hell.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want that money. Yeah, I will live, if it's a miserable life, I will live it and with my wife. I remember they have told even a lot of issue, a lot of things to my mom. They said, I don't give birth to a kid. I can't give birth to a kid.
Mm.
And this is the reason why I decided to marry a woman with a kid, because I can't give birth. And talking about this, I remember our second born, my wife conceived our second born when we were in Burundi, when he had joined me already in Burundi, we were both working over there. And then I told my, we went to visit mom in the up country, and I told mom, you know, mom, my wife is pregnant. She said, are you sure? You must be joking. Yeah, but I didn't know that she's doubting, because she had been told that I can't give a birth to a kid.
Mm.
And then she said, okay. Then she tested her own way, you know, those those people, those all people, they know how to test their stuff.
Huh? Yeah.
Yeah, she tested her own way. She asked him, asking me to give her a shoes, a shoe.
Mm-hmm.
And then I gave her a shoe. She put water in my shoe.
Mm.
She gave my wife to drink.
Eh?
Yes.
Why?
And she drank.
Why?
And she drank. She was testing if she was really
pregnant. Was really pregnant.
Yes.
Hey, is and that then something she's, people in Burundi
and,
do?
And I didn't even know about this.
And your wife and drank? Then,
yeah, she drank. And the mom told me, it's true.
She's pregnant.
So what, everything they have said is wrong. It's a lie. And I said, thanks to God. But we had to go through a lot because the company I was working for was a starting company.
Yeah.
And we could spend even 4 months without being paid. My wife was also being paid, but not a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
And now that she had conceived, and she was experiencing a lot of complication, we had to make a decision, a drastic decision. Since my brothers were not ready to support us, we had to make a drastic decision of coming back to Kenya to start from zero.
Mm.
And we came back to Kenya. We rent a house of a room for 7,500.
Mm.
I don't have a job. She doesn't have a job.
Mm.
She's about to deliver, to give birth. So it was terrible. So we thank God we survived. We don't know how we lived, how we managed to be paying the house rent, how we managed to get something to eat. But sometimes we could sleep hungry, and which is not also surprising, because even now sometimes we sleep hungry.
Even right now?
Yeah, even right now.
How your brothers are well off?
Yeah, they are well off.
They are millionaires.
Yeah.
And you are sleeping hungry.
Yeah, I'm sleeping hungry, but I can't even ask help from them. Yeah, because of their condition, they place conditions. So I have been surviving from the help of good friends. I have some friends. I must be thankful to Father Martin Soma in the USA, and also Pietro Alessandro Cafolio, a former teacher who taught me psychosynthesis, an Italian one. And they have been so supportive, and they have been the one helping me even to be able to pay the house rent, because it's not easy, because with this, my wife's salary, now we can only pay the house rent and the house help for my mom-in-law, because she's old and she's sickly, and we also have to take care of her.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, she lost her husband some 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to be there for her.
Yeah.
So you know, this is a very heavy burden for my wife alone.
Uh-huh.
I really pray to God so that I can get something to do, so that I can be able to support my lovely wife.
Yeah.
And yeah, you know, sometimes because this thing, I'm a teacher, even if it's it came that way. I did the teaching in the secondary, but at university I did different thing.
Mm-hmm.
But it came, I reached the time that I'd be doing teaching.
Mm.
I taught French and English as a second language. I taught French in the different places. And it didn't go well because most of the place where I teach, it's either they terminate my contract even without paying me a certain amount of money, and they just tell me that the contract is finished.
So even you now, are not able to keep a job?
Yeah, I'm not able to keep a job, and I don't understand what is really going on. I keep on praying so that maybe someday I could secure a very permanent job.
So you are telling me you are here, you are very qualified.
Yes.
You have experience.
Actually, I'm a graduate.
You are a graduate.
Yes.
But every time you get a job,
yes,
you are either terminated,
yes,
or they just give up on you.
Yes. Others, I do interviews, they never call me. Even on 20th, I did an interview with UNHCR to become a translator, an interpreter translator. Mm. I'm still waiting. Hopefully that maybe something comes up.
Why do you think that happens to you?
So I really don't know. I really don't understand. This is something I always question. I always question God, but I have not been able to get an answer.
Mm-hmm.
But I know, all I know is God's time is always the best.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there is something that God has planned for me, and I know once it comes, it will come
and
being something very big that we surprise the whole world, that we uplift the name of God. And also my dream has been to take my wife back to school, to set a business for her, business that goes in line with what
she loves.
Yeah, she loves.
Mm-hmm.
And also take her back to school until she completes maybe university studies.
Mm.
Yeah, that has been my dream. That's if I place a finger on something like a job, and maybe something like something I can do that can earn us a living.
Mm.
Yeah.
It must be so hard for you not to speak to your brothers, you know, the way siblings do. Because if I'm going through something, yeah, I want to be able to call my big sister or my small sisters and tell them,
yes,
I'm going through something. It must be hard for you to see them reject you like this.
Yeah, it's really hard and painful. But, you know, sometimes you do not have a choice. But now, if it happens that way, I just choose another way around of doing things. I need to have someone I confide my problems to. Mm-hmm. I share my problems,
mm-hmm,
with.
Mm-hmm.
And most importantly, it's my wife first, and also some of the friends I have been telling you, like Father Martin,
mm-hmm,
and also Pietro.
Talk to me about your wife. What makes you want to spend the rest of your lives together?
I got married being ready for marriage. You know, people get married for different reasons. I got married being ready for marriage, that's first. Secondly, my wife has shown me a great support, and has never disrespected me, and she knows what she wants in a marriage, and I'm sure what I want to be able to do,
mm,
once I'm still alive,
mm-hmm,
she can still accomplish it when I'm dead. This is in terms of taking care of the kids. She's a wife she's a wife. Any man that wishes to have a wife material would wish to have.
So you do not regret?
No, I do not regret at all. And I will never regret having her as my lovely wife.
Uh-huh.
Yes. And this is the reason why I don't hide anything from her. Anything. You can ask her, even my Facebook account, WhatsApp, she accesses my phones, pins, she knows, my bank account, she knows, the code, the pin, everything. So this is the reason why she's my friend. She's someone I can confide. She's someone I trust. She's all that I need.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's also very supportive.
Yeah.
Yes. And she doesn't look down upon me because she's providing now. And I'm not providing. She understands what I'm going through. And most importantly, that way,
mm-hmm.
That's the reason why I think I can't abandon her in any way, until death do us apart.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
When you are feeling really low, what keeps you going?
Yeah. Goodness, it's what keeps me going is when I look at my family, I look at my wife, how she works hard for the family. I look at my children, how we raise them in a God-fearing way, and I imagine about the future of the family. That keeps me going, and also gives me a hope of getting maybe something that will help us to be able to
to
help them to reach where they need to reach.
Yeah. Yeah. I know we'll be sitting with your wife, huh? Because we also need to hear how this has affected her. Yes. And what keeps her going too. But I always say I have an audience here that mm-hmm. is willing to support.
Yes.
And I know right now you do not have a job.
Yes.
And I love the fact that you are so open about it.
Yes.
You are not ashamed to sit here and say, I do not have a job. So
yes.
If you could take this opportunity maybe to yes. tell our audience, what
yes.
are your qualifications?
Yes.
So if someone is watching this interview,
yes.
they are able, even if they are not going to give you a job,
yes.
they can refer you
yes.
to a place you can drop your CV. Please
okay.
tell them what your qualifications are.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. I'm a graduate in general law. But also, I think it's a bit challenging being here in Kenya because I did a different law.
Mm-hmm.
So I did Romano-Germanic, which is done by French-speaking countries. But again, I'm a translator and interpreter
mm-hmm.
and French, English, and Swahili, and Kirundi too.
Mm-hmm.
I'm also a teacher, and I have a French teacher, and I can teach different programs, which means different in different system of education, like EdExcel at Cambridge, and also 844. I can teach French in those systems,
mm-hmm.
all of them, and actually I have a good experience. Almost 5 years, but it's only that I have not been able to secure a permanent job as a teacher.
Mm-hmm.
So I have been teaching, just doing tuitions and doing in a school for a certain time. So I'm able to teach French in many different system, mm-hmm. educational system, and also I'm translator, interpreter.
Yes.
Yeah, and now coming back to law, mm-hmm. I can only practice it in a French-speaking country.
Okay, yes. Lovely. And yes. When it comes to maybe small businesses, are you, yes. can you be able to hold a business?
Yeah, actually, I didn't mention that I happen to own a cyber, but unfortunately, a cyber and an M-Pesa, mm-hmm. Unfortunately, when in that trying to go back to Burundi, yeah. it went down, mm-hmm. and it stopped.
Okay.
I and my friend also tried to put up a school, mm-hmm. an international school. Mm-hmm. And I must say that we succeeded. Unfortunately, the guy we were together decided to do away with us. We were three of us, mm-hmm. and he kept the school and he made it something to con people. Mm-hmm. So we decided to advise the parents for the student. We already had 10 students, mm-hmm. and they were paying a lot of money, good money. I think each student was paying 65,000 per term. Mm-hmm. It was an international school, and mm-hmm. we had very qualified teachers, and we started that from nothing. Imagine.
So you are able to start, yeah. something from nothing.
Yes.
But you are able to, yes. do that, Gerard.
Oh, yeah.
At some point,
yes.
your brothers are going to watch this interview.
Okay.
What message do you have for them?
Yeah. Yeah, I really don't have anything against them. I love them like my brothers, and they are still my brothers. But I would like to tell them to respect someone's take, mm-hmm. take on something, someone's decision, because me being Gerard, I can't decide as you, being you. Yeah, we are different, and this is what make this world rich. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
If we decide the same way, the world won't go anywhere.
Exactly.
So it's good we respect each one's decision. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and especially, I must underline this one, when it comes to marriage. Mm-hmm. Because what I love in a woman is not what you love in a woman.
Exactly.
What you want in a wife is not what I want in a wife.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Exactly.
So when it comes to that one, I think I want to have a second option of doing what they call as disobeying them.
Mm-hmm.
Their decision.
Yeah.
Yes.
You made your choice and you're, yes. sticking with it.
Yes.
Talk to mom.
Oh. Hello, mom. You are the best mom in the world. I really can't imagine having you as mom the way you are, and remembering where we came from with you, and you never choose to abandon us. You stuck with us until this time. I love you so much. And I'm really sorry not being able to be of help, for the time being. But I promise you that when things goes well, I will always remember you and help you, give you the help you want, you deserve, as the best mom in the world. I love you.
Ayo, amazing. You call her? Do you call her? Do you guys talk?
Yes, yes.
So
we do talk.
You're in communication
yes,
with her?
So, yeah. Yes. Sometimes when I get, when I don't have a problem with my smartphone, mm-hmm. if I have, I can access WhatsApp.
Yes.
Yeah, I call my my younger brother.
Yeah.
So he connects me to them.
Yes.
Yeah, I speak to my mom. But now that I am having kabambe, so yeah.
You will get a smartphone, okay?
Amen.
And you will continue communicating.
Amen.
And Gerald, I really want to wish you all the best. And
thank
I also want
much.
To urge our audience, whoever is watching this interview, and you feel like you can come through for this family, refer him, you know, for a job where he can drop a CV. We yes. would gladly appreciate, because we want to sit here next time and
yes.
bring our audience a totally different story. So
thank you very much.
I know this was not easy for you to come and share your story, but I appreciate your courage.
Yes, not easy, but I really thank you for all the time you have and also all the stuff that you have put in place so that the interview can go well,
mm-hmm.
and also may God bless you and protect you.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
thank you so
much. You're really an inspiration to many people. I know this story will inspire so many people mm-hmm. out there, and this is what moved me, what motivated me to give this story, so mm-hmm. that I can inspire someone, we can inspire someone out there who is maybe in the same situation like mm-hmm. our situation.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right. Thank you so much, lovely people, for watching. Please remember this family in your prayers. And as you know, we have a Patreon program that you can join. We want to continue bringing you inspirational stories that will continue impacting the world, but we also need your help to make this happen. So you can find our Patreon link on the description box. Please feel free to join in and contribute towards us bringing you more amazing stories. Don't forget, we are going to be sitting down with Gerald's wife, because we also need to hear from her and see how this has affected her and her family. Please stay tuned for part two of this story. My name is Lynn Ngugi. See you soon.